Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. In this video, we will discuss Class 11 Mathematics, Chapter 16, Probability, Exercise 16.1, Question Number 9 to 12 Solution. A box contains one red and three identical white balls. Two balls are drawn at random in succession without replacement. Write the sample space for this experiment. In this question, there is a box and inside that box, there is a red ball and three white balls. And these three white balls are identical. So we have to take two balls one after the other without replacing. That means, see, each time you have to take here two balls. So after taking one ball, you can't put that ball back inside the box before taking the second one. So that is not possible. So now let us find the sample space for this experiment. So here we have one red ball and three white balls which are identical. So for that purpose, see, now let us say that you have taken one ball from the box and that box is red ball. Then next here you can't put after recording this R again inside this box. You have to take the second ball because they have given here two balls are drawn at random in succession without replacement. So take another ball from the box. Let us say that that ball is W. So you get the outcome RW. After noting this particular outcome, just you put these two balls inside the box. Then again, let us say that you have taken the first ball and that first ball is R. Again, you took the second ball and second ball is this W. Then you get the outcome RW. Again, you got RW. Now, again, let us say that third time you have taken the ball from the box and then you got R and then this W. See here you can observe here in each of these cases we got RW, 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 which we can consider as one outcome which is RW. The reason is here they have given the white balls are identical. So that's why all these three balls we consider as a one unit. Suppose if they have not mentioned anything regarding this identical, then you can name these balls as W1, W2, W3. In that case, you may get the outcome RW1, RW2, RW3 for these combinations. But as now they have given white balls are identical, so that's why we are considering these three balls as single unit. So you are taking the outcome as RW. Next, let us say that again you have taken two balls from the box. That time you got two white balls. See here, as the balls are identical, you can't differentiate them. So even though in this case there are three possibilities, you may get this combination or you may get this combination or you may get this combination. In each of these combinations, you get WW. So WW, WW, WW you may get. But the balls are identical. We consider this as a single unit. So we take here outcome as WW. Next, let us say that you have taken first white ball, then red ball. In that case also, you can have actually three options, WR, then WR, then WR. But here we are taking this as identical, so we consider all these three as together as one unit, so WR. So here the sample space S is equal to RW, WW, WR. The same sample space changes if these three balls are different. If we have W1, W2, W3, in that case, we can have 9 outcomes. But as here the balls are identical, we have here just 3 outcomes. Question number 10. An experiment consists of tossing a coin and then throwing it second time if a head occurs. If a tail occurs on the first toss, then a die is rolled once. Find the sample space. So here in this experiment, first we have to toss a coin. We know that when we toss a coin, there are two possibilities. We may get either head or tail. Then they have given throwing it second time if a head occurs. When we toss the coin first time, if we get head, then we have to throw the same coin again. So that again gives two possibilities, head or tail. Then they have given, if a tail occurs on the first time, then a die is rolled. So here, in this case, first time when you toss a coin, if you get head, then again you have to toss the coin. Suppose if you get tail, then you have to roll a die. So this is the experiment. Now see, in this case, we know that when we roll a die, there are six possibilities. So for this, we have to write the sample space now. See, if I consider this part, see here, we can have two possible outcomes. Either it may be first time we may get head and then second time we may get head. So head. First time it is head only, then here we may get tail. So head, tail. Then with respect to this one, we can have six possibilities. This is tail only. So tail 1, then T2, T3, T4, T5, T6. Because they have given the die is rolled only when if the tail occurs. So this is T only these values changes. So for this we can have the sample space S is equal to HH, HT, T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, T6. Question number 11. Suppose 3 bulbs are selected at random from a lot. Each bulb is tested and classified as defective or non-defective. Write the sample space for this experiment. See here there are 3 bulbs and they have given each bulb may give 2 possibilities. When we test a bulb, the result may be defective or non-defective. So let us take 3 bulbs as B1, B2, B3. So if you test a single bulb, then there you can have 2 possibilities, defective we represent as D or non-defective as N. So like this way, here we have 3 bulbs, so these are the possibilities now. So each bulb has 2 possibilities. So here, this particular experiment is similar to tossing a coin thrice. If you toss a coin 3 times, then you get 2 to the power 3 is equal to 8 possibilities. Because in the case of tossing a coin also, the possible answers are 2, head or tail. So 2, then we are tossing 3 coins, so 3, 2 to the power 3 is equal to 8. Here also, there are 2 possible outcomes, defective or non-defective, that's why 2. And there are 3 bulbs, so 2 to the power 3 is equal to 8. Now we have to write those possible outcomes. See here, let us say that in the first case, the bulb is defective. The second case, the bulb is defective. And in the third case, also defective. Then we can have the combination DD. Let us say that the first case is defective. Second case, is second bulb is defective. And the third bulb is non-defective. Then we can have the combination DDN. But if you write like this way, that may take long time as well as you may get some confusion also. So that's why to avoid that confusion, there is the easiest method to write these outcomes. That method is, see, first of all, you have to see here the total number of outcomes. Here there are 4 outcomes and 2 possible results. Sorry, here there are 8 outcomes and 2 possible results. So divide this 8 by 2. So if you divide this 8 by 2, then we get here 4. So there are 2 possibilities, that means each possibility you have to write 4 times. So D, 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 then N, 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 N. After that, divide this 4 by 2, then you get 2. So in the next line, write each possibility 2 times. So D, D, N, N, D, D, N, N. Next you divide this by 2, then you get 1. So in the next line, write each possibility 1 time. So D, N, D, N, D, N, D, N. So now you compare with these outcomes, both are similar. So by this way, you can find the outcome. So now here we can write the sample space S as D, 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 N, D, N, D, D, N, 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 D, D, N, D, N, 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 D, N, N, N. Question number 12. A coin is tossed if the outcome is a head. A die is thrown. If the die shows up an even number, then die is thrown again. What is the sample space for the experiment? So in this experiment, see, first they toss a coin. And we know that when we toss a coin, there are 2 possibilities, head or tail. If the outcome is head, then we have to throw a die. So now let us say that we got head, then we have to throw a die. And die means we have 6 possibilities, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then again, if the die shows an even number, while throwing the die, let us say that you got even number. Then you have to throw the die once again. So here see, in this case, the even number possibilities are 3. Either you may get 2, 4 or 6. So if you get any one of these number 2, 4 or 6, then you have to throw the die again. That they have given. If the die shows up an even number, the die is thrown again. So for 2, 4 and 6, we have to throw the die again. So that here we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, 6 possibilities. So this is about the representation of this problem. Now let us write the outcome. See here, first we are tossing the coin so that there are 2 possibilities, head or tail. If we get the tail, then no need to continue. We have to stop the process. So one possibility we can write as tail. Then if we get the head, then we have to throw a die, where in this case also, suppose if you get an even number, then you have to throw the die again. But if you get an odd number, you can stop the process. So we can have the next outcome as H1, H3, H5. Because if you get odd number, we are not throwing the die. Next, if you get a even number, then you have to throw a die. Further, you get 6 possibilities. So, H21, then H22, H23, H24, H25, H26. Similarly, if you get 4, which is an even number, again you have 6 possibilities. So, H41, H42, H43, H44, H45, H46. Again, if you get 6, which is an even number, so you have 6 possibilities, H61, H62, H63, H64, H65, H66. So here we can have the sample space as S is equal to T, H1, H3, H5. This is for odd number of die. Then H21, H22, H23, H24, H25, H26. This is the even number 2 of the first die throw. Then H41, H42, H43, H44, H45, H46. This is for the even number 4 of first throw of die. Then next we have even number 6 outcome, H61, H62, H63, H64, H65, H66. This is about question number 9 to 12. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. Thanks for watching.